evening. I'm Minette Streeter, and this is Music and Taxes International. This is going to be a very special broadcast. The ideas for this were generated by watching television for the past couple of weeks and listening to issues that were being addressed and issues that could seriously affect our economy. With that said, I started thinking about if some of these issues actually came to pass, how would it affect the musicians and how would it affect the entertainment community? All of these issues revolve around oil. O-I-L. Oil. Let's take a look at this chart. It's really a very important and interesting chart that anybody can find. And it has a list of products made from petroleum, 144 of 6,000 items. That gives you an idea of how vast the petroleum products are in our daily life. But in the life of a musician, in the life of the entertainment industry, if oil was cut off for any reason, slight or major, for any reason, what would happen with the entertainment and music industry? Well, let's see. Oil goes into cassettes. Oil goes into CD players. Oil goes into all of these types of things that are in daily life, including speakers. Oil goes into tires, okay? Oil goes into television cabinets. Oil goes into car battery cases. You getting the picture? That means that if anything happened to drops of oil or gallons of oil or barrels of oil, how's that going to affect the daily musician? Number one, if he has jobs and oil caused a cutoff in fuel, he would have no transportation. What happens to bands? If oil was cut off for any reason, they would not be able to fulfill contracts. They would not have concerts. They would not have transportation. They would not have 18-wheelers that would be moving their speakers and all of their equipment from one city to another. They would have to refund a huge amount of tickets. Okay? Their contracts could possibly be taken by a very good legal beagle, and they could be held liable because a lot of these contracts do not include clauses that hold them harmless. So we're getting into some very serious issues if oil was at stake. And we have to look at that very carefully. How big is oil? Well, let's see. The oil industry is one of the major industries on this planet. And oil is in major countries, major bodies of water. Is planet-wide, not just worldwide, planet-wide. Oil regulates, absolutely regulates, the transportation of goods and services throughout the world. And therefore, if anything happened to oil, the global economy would come to a standstill. But by the same token, let's look at something else. And let's look at the health and well-being of the oil rig worker. And this stems from my years in medical and emergency medical experience. And so I think about that oil rig worker who in today's life, if they have an injury, is a specialty area in recovery. I have talked to many extremely intelligent medical professionals, doctors and technicians, who are now working with oil rig injuries out here in the Gulf of Mexico, not too far from my city right here, Pensacola, Florida. And they are able to determine that recovery is a specialty area. And we're going to do a feature on that later on. But what I am addressing, and this is my personal touch from me to you, and that is we need a very serious and intelligent set of medical conferences in one large city, inviting those from the American medical community in conjunction with the international medical community. Probably about 5 days it would take it. The media, the entertainment community, and lawyers to discuss one thing, and that is medical needs of oil rig workers, the boat captains for the oil rigs that supply the facilities and the food and the equipment going back and forth from land to the oil rigs. They have accidents also. Televise this and put it into segments on cable television in the United States. Why? Because we have thousands of medical technicians, nurses, and doctors in the U.S. that would not be able to attend an international conference on oil rig medicine, but they need to be able to see it because they are taking care of the oil rig worker. Yes, this is a new dimension. This is a new area that has to be addressed, and thank goodness we are getting ready to address this. In closing, I want to say this. I speak for myself. Sometimes the world has to have a catalyst for why they want peace. And maybe oil is the one thing that is going to be the lifetime catalyst for peace, because our economic future is totally dependent upon it. Until next month, I'm Minette. This is Music and Taxes, wishing you success, wealth, and prosperity, and lots of good business. In peace. Good night.